So we have a pretty good idea about how this substation construction project will be put together. And Jake gave us a good indication about the intricacies involved in the process. And like any new build, it always starts from the ground up with what Unitil calls civil work. And that's what we'll be looking at first. Before actual work begins, I'm meeting Sarah SANKOWICH to walk us through the tree clearing that is just about to start.
All right. Hey, Sarah, how are you?
Good, all right.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
What have we got going on here?
We are doing some land clearing.
I got to wear this,
huh? I got for you.
All right. Take me along. Show me what's happening.
This is a first stage of clearing the land for our new substation that's going in here.
Okay. And so the very first thing when you get here is to do what? To cut the trees and then put them in a pile? What's the process?
Oh, first we had a survey done, so we knew the limits of our land and figured out where the substation is going to go and what trees actually have to be cleared. So what the crews are doing here is they're actually cutting down the area, clearing the land, and pile the trees here. Some of them will be used for lumber, and then we'll have the rest of them all chipped up with the chipper there. And those will actually be used for biomass where we burn them.
All right, I can take some home with me for some wood projects. This is a nice pine here.
Yeah.
So what about these machines? Tell me about these different machines that you're working with.
Well, we have a feller buncher that does the actual cutting. And then once the logs are cut, we have a forwarder.
And what does that do? That just carries the bundles out?
Yeah, it carries stuff that's been cut, loads it all up, puts it out here ready to be moved off-site or chipped up. So we're just basically clearing the land so that we can have the substation built here. So all of these lines will be moved over this way to accommodate the bigger substation.
Right, right. So think about it. When you get up in the morning, you turn on the TV, make some coffee, use the microwave. These are all things we take for granted. But how does that happen? Well, it's from the very hard work of the public utility company and electrical line workers. But it's a very dangerous job. How do they do it safely? Well, they all have a very deep understanding of all the proper safety rules and proper electrical protective equipment. Hey, Nikki. How are you?
Hey, Brian.
Good to
see you. How are you? Good to see you.
Jake gave us an overview of the substation plans for Kingston, which is very complex, and it looks like there are a lot of safety hazards we have to think about.
There are a lot of hazards, and we have a lot of contractors and employees working out there. So we want to make sure that they're all trained and have the proper equipment before they get out on site.
And that's what I want to get to next. I see some equipment over here. What are the first things you need to do if we're going to go out on the site?
So the first thing we need is a hard hat.
Mm-hmm.
Protects your head from any overhead falling objects.
Okay.
Second thing, safety glasses.
Yeah.
Couple things. These are shatter resistant. They also have side shields that protect your eyes if anything were to come in from the side.
Right.
So you need to have these on at all times on this site.
Okay.
We want to make sure that you're seen. People that are on site, passersby, people that are driving by. It's high visibility, reflective material on here. So I'll give that
all right.
to you.
And finally, I think I see the world famous steel-toed shoes,
yes,
right? Those
yes,
are essential.
Yes, that's the other piece of PPE that everybody needs to have. So these are also required.
All right, thank you.
All right, bye.
Next up, we'll watch as the crew starts the foundation.
We're back with Nate again. Hey, Nate, how are you?
Hey, Brian, good to see you.
This looks like this is like a myriad of wire. Did these poles, there's no foundation, they just drill these right into the ground?
Correct, yep. The digger's basically a big drill and it drills into the earth.
Right.
And these poles are set, you know, anywhere from 6 to 8 feet in the ground.
So one of the first things I notice is we're down low. I mean, probably 4 feet below grade. Why are we down here?
Right. In the site design, there's some elevations that are specified. And another aspect of it is they need to get down to earth that's stable enough to support foundations.
Is that your design, your area?
No, what we did, we hired TFMoran, and Nick Golon was the engineer for this project from TFMoran to help us out.
Hey, Nick, good to see you. How are you?
Hey, Nick.
Hey, good to see you, Nick.
So we're at the very early stages of this project, and this is probably, I think, the most important because it's the footing, it's below, it's everything that's happening that's going to support this new substation. What is your role in the overall site in the project?
Well, the best way I can explain it is really our work starts as a site civil engineer, where Nate's work leaves off relative to the substation. Pretty much that substation fence. Everything inside the fence, it's Nate's domain. We really take care of everything outside of it. And as you said, it's a very important process as far as how we work with the site grades to transition out towards the limits of the property. Now, there's a couple of things that we need to do. First, we work hand in hand, basically, with Nate to establish what that elevation of the yard needs to be.
Right.
That's important because you need to make sure your stormwater can drain off the site to a natural point. Yep. And you also need to make sure that that elevation is set so that we can tie out our grades at the limit of the property.
So Nick, we're going down into some sort of a trench or a depression of some sort here between the work site and the landscape.
That's right. This is our bioretention area. And you hit the nail on the head. It is a shallow depression with the purpose of storing our stormwater after it comes off of the substation yard.
So it comes off the substation, comes in here. Now, is this special soil? Does it,
it is.
Drain properly?
Now, what this is an engineered soil. We've determined essentially what its infiltrative capacity is. How quickly can the stormwater go through the soil?
Right.
What's made up of this, it's pretty simple. You know, we're trying to basically reinvent what Mother Nature did, or duplicate it, mm-hmm. I should say. We've got sand, we've got some compost, and we've got some loam.
So they each serve a different purpose.
Very true, and the aggregate, the total mixture, serves to filter stormwater as it leaves the site.
Maybe we should hop back in and see.
Yeah, let's go take a look. They're working on foundations now. So
sounds good.
I appreciate it.
We've got some inspections to do.
Absolutely.
Right. Good to meet you.
Good to see you, Nick.
All right.
Good to see
you.
All right. Take care.
Okay, so we're kind of down here at this subgrade level, and I see a lot of forms and concrete. What's going on at this level?
So what they're doing right now is they're making all the foundations. So the first step is they use rebar, which is it's steel rebar that looks like this, or it comes in different sizes and shapes. And they do that to make a kind of a rebar cage, we call it. And they make that for the footings as well as these, which we call the piers.
Now, do they put it in on site, or it doesn't come pre-assembled? They pour the concrete?
It's all assembled on site. So they have drawings that tell them here's how much rebar, the size of it,
right?
The spacing. So they lay it all out, they tie it together, and then what they do is they use these forms to build around the rebar to make the foundation the size that the drawings say they have to be.
Oh, I see.
And then the concrete comes and they pour the concrete in.
Okay, and then up top here I see we've got some bolts.
Yeah, so
pretty big hefty bolts.
Yeah, so what this is for is these are built up, there's rebar in it, and then they put these anchor bolts in. And these are all spaced differently for each foundation, and they're spaced to match the steel structures that we're going to be putting on them.
It's eventually like
build
that
a substation.
Over here. Yeah,
exactly.
What it's
going to
look like. Yeah.
So all of that's going to sit on top of this foundation. Some of these over here are just, we call them pads. So the big one over there is going to support the power transformer.
That's a big
so
one.
So I think the power transformer weighs 240,000 pounds. So all that is going to sit on that piece of cement right there.
It's got to be pretty hefty.
So the next step will be they're going to lie the conduits on the ground. They're going to start filling and put some more conduits a little higher up. And then they're going to put in the ground grid. Also, the cable trench will go in around that level. And then the final grade of the substation will be filled up to here. So that'll be right across. You'll see over there the big transformer pad. That's where the transformer is going to sit. So all that, you'll see about a foot on the tops of each foundation, and that's it.
So there's some more work to be done before the actual backfill comes in.
Yeah.
And I think we're going to have to definitely come back and check that out when we can before
probably,
that happens.
Yeah, probably a few weeks.
Pan out for now.
All
appreciate
right.
it, man.
Good
we'll
to see you, Brian.
Soon. Thanks.
Take care.
Once the concrete sets, Unitil will be ready for laying down conduit and installing the ground grid. Since watching concrete dry is no fun, we'll check back in with them in the next chapter.